Dr. Laura is on right now.
Here's the deal. I wrote a book called The Proper Care and Feeding of Marriage. And in that is this little story, my rendition of O. Henry's Gift of the Magi. Because people say there is no such thing as a perfect marriage, and I think that's not true. I think there are perfect marriages. Are there little wrinkles and glitches? Little, minor. But ultimately, it's a perfect marriage. And so my first recognition of a perfect marriage was reading The Gift of the Magi. So here it is. Two young people, married, it's in the 1800s. They're poor. At night, he goes out and finds pieces of coal and wood so they can burn it and not be cold. They obviously have no money, and Christmas is coming. So they make a pact. Not that they have to, because there's no money. That they're not going to get each other gifts. That they're just going to be joyous. That they're alive and have each other. Okay. So Christmas comes, and they're sitting there holding hands. And then he hands her a box. And she says, I thought we were not giving each other gifts. And he says, open it. She opens it, and in it is this beautiful, bejeweled hair comb, you know, that women used to wear that stood up and held. If you had long hair, you'd sort of knot it up and then stick that, and it would keep it in place. But a beautiful one. Tears come to her eyes. Not just because it's beautiful. From under her skirts, she pulls a box. He says, I thought we weren't giving each other gifts. Open the box. He opens the box, and it's a solid gold chain that attaches to the solid gold watch that's been passed down in his family for several generations that he has. It's a family heirloom. They look at each other, and she pulls the scarf off her head, and she's cut her hair. Her hair went down past her tush, went down to her kneecaps. She's been growing hair her whole life. She sold the hair for the money to buy the gold chain for his gold watch, which he sold to buy her the bejeweled comb. That's a perfect marriage. Each one of them sacrificed something that was so dear for the pleasure of the other. Now, what if you woke up every morning with your spouse, looked at them, and thought, what can I do to make him, her happy they're alive and married to me? What can I do? Sometime today, if not now, that would make him or her happy they're alive and married to me. What if you folks, married folks, did that every morning? What do you think your marriage would be like if you did the thing that came to mind? What do you really think your marriage would be like?